Okay, this episode is about death. And I was biking home tonight, just spent 3 hours lifting at the gym. And I tend to have my most profound insights either in the morning when I drink my coffee or after my long workouts. And I'm sure it has a lot to do with endorphins and all the feel-good neurotransmitters. Anyhow, death. You think about it more and more as you get older. We all do. And we really do not need to fear death, because death is like being in a deep sleep. But we do need to fear being physically and psychologically dead, so to speak, by living low quality lives, by not taking care of our body and exercising. We do need to worry about feeling depressed, anxious, because we're not using our body and mind out in nature, for instance. For example, I was watching a documentary last night about how noise reduces our ability to taste food and enjoy food as much, because the noise takes away from the sensory perception of taste. Anyhow, that's just one of many examples of why we need to be out in nature. So, number one, don't fear death. Number two, you should fear having a low quality existence on this planet while you're here, neglecting your body, and as a result, your mind and the feel-good brain chemicals, the serotonin, dopamine. So the next question is, if everyone lived to feel good and to take care of themselves, what would happen to the world? And the world would keep going. If we all lived like me, it would slow down the GDP. There'd be less production of things, stuff. The GDP would be lower. Other countries may catch up to us or surpass us. People would be happier. People around you would be happier. We wouldn't be sitting in our cars in traffic jams and going to a cubicle to work. But it would slow down the GDP if everybody lived like me. And unfortunately, other countries, maybe China, would get ahead of us. So I don't really care about that. I don't care if China gets ahead of us. I'll be long gone before that is of any concern, and even if they do, should we care? Sweden, Norway, Denmark, they're not big, powerful countries, and they live more the way I do, and they've survived. They have low GDPs compared to the United States. Anyhow, that's my spiel. My insight today about death and how we do not need to fear death, but we do need to fear not living in the now and neglecting our becoming sick psychologically, physically, and suffering while we are alive. Now, these things seem very obvious, but most people don't probably verbalize these types of thoughts, even though most of us will think these thoughts at some point. So once again, for my children, hopefully it'll be of help. Goodbye from a wonderful evening out here near the brewery. Skateboarder out here tonight, enjoying the trail. St. Michelle Winery right over there. Great sunset. And Rainier showing in the distance, but you can't see it through the trees. Goodbye.